The elder loves tales to his grandson, and is well pleased in martial criticism of the life of man. Downloading from www.hollywood.com. All and everything first series. 10 books in 3 series. First series, 3 books under the title of The Elder Loves Tales to His Grandson. And objectively impartial. Chapter 1. Be aroused in thought.
the relationship, why he did this. He emptied his glass at a draft and, on the famous Georgian song, drink up again, boys, obligatory when drinking, he began in a leisurely way to answer as follows. Since you drink wine not as people would today, that is, merely for appearances, but in fact honestly, this already shows me that, unlike our engineers and technicians who plague me with questions, you wish to know about this practice of mine not out of curiosity but from a genuine desire for knowledge, and therefore I wish, and even consider it my duty, to confess to you sincerely the exact reason for the inner to the face scrupulous considerations that led me to this. He then related the following. Formerly I used to work in this station at night cleaning the boilers, but when they put in the steam whistle, the station master, evidently considering my age and incapacity for the heavy work I was doing, gave me the one job up. Releasing the steam into the whistle, for which I had to arrive punctually every morning and evening. The very first week of my new service, I noticed that after performing this duty of mine I felt vaguely ill at ease for an hour or two. But when this queer feeling, increasing day by day, eventually became a definite instinctive uneasiness from which even my appetite for mako disappeared, I began to rack my brains in order to find out the cause. I thought about it with particular intensity. For some reason or other, while going to and coming from my work, but however hard I tried I could not make anything clear to myself, even approximately. Things went on like this for almost 6 months, and the palms of my hands had become calloused from the rope of the steam whistle when, quite suddenly and accidentally, I understood why I was experiencing this uneasiness. The shock that brought about a correct understanding, resulting in the formation of an unshakable conviction, with a certain exclamation I happened to hear in the following rather peculiar circumstances. One morning when I had not had enough sleep, since I spent the first half of the night at the christening of my neighbor's ninth daughter, and the other half reading a rare and very interesting book I had come across entitled Dreams and Witchcraft, I was hurrying on my way to release the steam, when I suddenly saw at a street corner a barber surgeon I knew, employed in the local government service, who beckoned me to stop. The function of this barber surgeon friend of mine was to go through the town at certain hours, accompanied by an assistant pushing a specially constructed cart, and to seize all the stray dogs whose collars lacked the metal tags issued by the local authorities on payment of the tax. He then had to take these dogs to the municipal slaughterhouse, where they were kept for 2 weeks at the town's expense and fed on slaughterhouse offal. If by the end of this period their owners had not planned